So good morning, friends. Today we will see how to fix S1 violation. So now you see here, there are seven S1 violations are there. So in my do file, I'm just wanted to show you how to clear these S1 violations. So now, set. Okay, now run. Yeah, just I am going to run the program. Yeah, now you can see here there are seven S1 violations are there. So we'll see it in visually. Open VI. In visualizer, if you go for the S1 violations, there are the seven S1 violations are there. So one by one, we will clear it. So first you will see here, this one is asynchronous set reset problem. So this can be fixed by inserting an OR gate. So output of the OR gate is connected here, and input of the OR gate is connect. One input of this OR gate is connected to here, this line. So output is this line. And one input is connected to this line, and other input is connected to scan enable or test mode pin. So for that, we should break this connection. For that, we have to remove this connection and we have to insert in one OR gate here. So we'll do it practically. So for that, I'm going to the do file. So now I'm just what I'm doing now, just I'm entering into the insertion mode. So I am defining the test mode enable pin and scan enable pin. Then after I am entering into the setup mode. In the setup mode, I am adding the pin constraints as C1, test mode 1, and scan enable is high. Now I am entering into the scan insertion mode. So in this insertion mode, so I am just deleting this connection. Okay, delete this connection. So this connection is this one. This one, so just copy this path. So deleting this connection. So then after what I'm doing now, just I'm creating an instance with the module name of R21. So this will be available in our library. So it is an OR gate, two inputs and one output. So here you see the output of this one is connected to output of this one is connected to this pin. So you see here the output of OR gate is connected here. So this one incrcrez/rm. And next one is one input A input is connected to DMSELREZQ. So this Q. DMSELREZ. So this queue. So now you see it is connected to this one. And next one is another input. Another input is connected to the test mode. So already defined it is a T1 test mode. So now I am going to remove this. For this control V. Sorry. Escape, control V, down arrow, it will select all. Just shift, delete. And also control V, down arrow, shift, delete. So now I has enabled all these signals. Now I am saving it and running it. For that, we are in setup mode. You just exit it, and now CSH run S1. Previously, we have seven violations. Now you may see those are reduced to six violations. Now we have only six S1 violations. So we'll see it graphically. Yeah, if you see here, there are six S1 violations. Six S1 violations. Suppose if you want to know it, actually it is a previous. This is a new one. So we, I'm just deleting this one. So I want to know the previous one. So for that, I'm just entering into the previous connection. Just copy it. Double click and paste here. Yes or not? You see here, this is a gate. Here we inserted R gate. And one input is, one of its input is connected to the test mode pin, and other input is connected to the previous REZ, DMSEL REZ. So test mode pin, and this is connected to the this reset. So in this case, if test mode pin during the entire test operation, so this test mode pin is one, so that the output of this AND gate, NOT gate is zero. So this reset pin is zero, so that we can able to control this flap. Okay, this way we can able to fix the set asynchronous set reset problem using the teseting tool. Thank you all.